there's some new hope.
News 5's Michelle Hopkins has more on the efforts to keep it afloat.
There is so much focus on political campaigns right now with names like McCain and Obama, but there's another campaign with another name, Delta. A lot of folks trying to save the Delta Queen, and that campaign is picking up steam.
With the little over a month until D-Day for the Delta Queen, a rally today in Maysville meant to fire up their base.
We don't have a budget. We're just out here pounding the pavement and trying to let people know that this is something special.
The Delta Queen is 81 years old, one of the last steamboats still taking passengers on overnight trips along the Ohio and Mississippi rivers. A 1966 law meant for ocean liners limits the amount of wood a passenger vessel can have.
The boat is in the greatest condition of its life. Incredible safety aspects have been added on, from sprinkler systems to heat and fire detection systems, a trained fire crew, everything you can imagine to offset the potential risks of some of the wooden structure on board.
On board the Queen today, we saw for ourselves fire alarms, smoke detectors, and extinguishers everywhere you look.
It would be a pure act of evil to let this boat die, and I'm not exaggerating. There's no reason for it.
Still, supporters have until October 31st to get an exemption passed in Congress.
This is a living part of our history. It's not a dusty old museum where you walk on and think, gee, I wonder what it was like to ride on one of these boats. Here you do it.
The only hope, legislation to grant another exemption to the law.
Unless there's enough support for that effort in Congress, the Delta Queen is all but doomed. It could be docked November 1st. Reporting in Maysville, Michelle Hopkins, News 5.